I'm Bobby Welber with the top five stories from the first 2 weeks of 2020 from Hudson Valley Post. A local business that will feature cocktails from local spirits finally opened after months of waiting and is looking to hire staff. Just before Christmas, the Hudson Valley Food Hall and Market called it an early Christmas miracle and announced that the Roosevelt Bar is now open after many months of waiting. The business is located at the former Roosevelt Theater on Main Street in Beacon. According to the company's website, the Hudson Valley Food Hall and Market will showcase a variety of food from the area. People are continuing to pack their bags and not come back to New York State. For the second year in a row, the Empire State lost more people than any other state, according to new data. It shows that New York lost nearly 77,000 people by July of last year. Officials say since 2010, 1.4 million people have left the state. The decline could mean that New York may lose one or two congressional seats when district lines are redone this year. A man whose body was recovered from the water beneath a bridge in Ulster County was identified as a 29-year-old from Red Hook. Witnesses say the man parked his car on the Kingston-Rhinecliff Bridge on New Year's Day and then jumped over the side just before 3 p.m. The death is believed to be a suicide. The man's name has not yet been released and the investigation is ongoing. Bruce Willis sold his beautiful Hudson Valley home for a fraction of the price that he hoped. Last January, Willis and his wife put their Westchester home on the market for just under $13 million. The home features amazing views of the Croton Reservoir and includes 22.6 acres as well as four houses for a total of 12 bedrooms. The actor said he loved the home, but he needed to sell it to be closer to family and friends on the West Coast. Around Christmas, the home sold for $7.6 million, over 40% off the home's original listing price. Senator Chuck Schumer is demanding a federal investigation into TJ-Maxx and its Marshalls and HomeGood brands by the Consumer Product Safety Commission. Schumer says a variation of 19 different products were sold in more than 3,200 U.S. stores, ranging from clothes to toys and electronics, after they were already recalled between 2014 and 2019. Most of the merchandise was highly dangerous and it could cause infant fatalities, as well as fire, burning, choking, falls, lacerations, skin irritation, and explosions, just to name a few. Schumer added that the consumers deserve to be notified, refunded, and reassured that this will not happen again. For more stories that the Hudson Valley is sharing, check out HudsonValleyPost.com.